Hello everyone, welcome to the series PIB 24/7. I am your mentor Manish Mishra, and in this session we'll discuss 5 MCQs from the PIB news. So let's begin with the first question, which says the National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority has accorded sanction to the establishment of Price Monitoring and Resource Unit in Jammu and Kashmir. Which among the following is not a function of Price Monitoring and Resource Unit? So this National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority was established to control the prices of pharmaceutical drugs in India. Okay, and it was established in 1997 under drugs price control order 1995. Okay, drugs price control order 1995 ke andar isko establish kiya gaya tha. Okay, and it is basically an attached office under Department of Pharmaceuticals, which works under Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, headed by Sadanand Gowda, whose Lok Sabha constituency is North Bangalore. Okay, and this NPPA, National Pricing Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, it releases list of medicine and their maximum ceiling prices. Okay, list of medicines and their maximum ceiling prices ये release करता है समय समय पे, ताकि उससे ज़्यादा prices पे वो दवाइयाँ ना बिक पाएं. Okay, and this Price Monitoring and Resource Unit, it is basically a registered society which will function under the direct control and supervision of the state drug controller of the respective state, जहाँ पे भी इसको establish किया गया है. सबसे पहला PMRU was established in Kerala, and now after Jammu and Kashmir there will be 12 PMRU in India. Okay, and this PMRU will be funded by National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, and there are some functions of PMRU which includes that it will help NPPA and state drug controller in ensuring availability and accessibility of medicines at affordable prices. It will organize seminars, training programs and other information, education and communication activities in the areas of availability and affordability of medicines for all. It will also collect samples of medicines and make a report with respect to availability and overpricing of medicines for taking actions under the provisions of drug price control order. Okay, now the question was, we have to identify that which of the following is not a function of PMRU. So let's come to the options. Option number A is monitors the availability of essential medicines. Yes, it monitors the availability of essential medicines. Next is it organizes seminars and training programs. Yes, related to availability and affordability of medicines. And next is it controls the prices of life-saving medicines. No, this is the function of National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, NPPA. Okay, so therefore C must be the right answer. Okay, so I hope this question is clear now. Next question is, National Pension Scheme and Atal Pension Yojana are the pension schemes to provide old age security to citizens of India. As on 31st March 2020, the total number of subscribers under NPS and Atal Pension Yojana has crossed 3.45 crores, which is the regulatory body of these two schemes. Let us first discuss about these two schemes. So Atal Pension Yojana was launched in 2015 for those workers who works in the unorganized sector. ठीक है, और इसके लिए जो एलिजिबिलिटी एज एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया है वो है 18 to 14, एंड द एप्लीकेशन शुड नॉट बी अ मेंबर ऑफ एनी सोशल सिक्योरिटी स्कीम एंड ऑल्सो ही शुड नॉट बी एन इनकम टैक्स पेयर. ओके, एंड द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इज फ्रॉम ₹42 to ₹291, दैट डिपेंड्स ऑन द एज ऑफ द एप्लीकेंट, एंड द गवर्नमेंट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इज 50% ऑफ द टोटल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन और ₹1000 विच एवर इज लोअर. ओके, और जो पेंशन मिलेगी वो मिलेगी ₹1000 से ₹5000 तक, जो कि वेरी करेगी एज पर द कंट्रीब्यूशन फ्रॉम द एप्लीकेंट आफ्टर द एज ऑफ 60. ओके, ₹1000 से ₹5000 तक की पेंशन अटल पेंशन योजना में मिलती है. ऑलराइट, नेक्स्ट इज नेशनल पेंशन स्कीम. सो दिस पेंशन स्कीम वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2004 फॉर गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज, बट इन 2009 इट वॉज ओपन टू ऑल द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया ऑफ एज 18 to 65. ओके, एंड इसमें एक प्रोविजन है कि आफ्टर रिटायरमेंट और एग्जिट फ्रॉम द स्कीम द कॉर्पस इज मेड अवेलेबल विद द मैंडेट दैट सम पोर्शन ऑफ द कॉर्पस मस्ट बी इन्वेस्टेड इनटू सम एन्युटी विच विल प्रोवाइड अ मंथली पेंशन आफ्टर रिटायरमेंट और एग्जिट फ्रॉम द स्कीम. ओके, एंड In 2018, government has made NPS an entirely tax-free instrument in India. And now let me tell you that both of these schemes are regulated by Pension Fund Regulatory Development Authority of India. So therefore, the question was, which is the regulatory body of these two schemes? So therefore, the answer is Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority. Okay, and these two pensions was in news because the total number of subscribers has crossed 3.45 crores mark. Okay. Now let's move on to the next question, guys. On the recommendations of the empowered group of 10 officers, the government has launched the National Monitoring Dashboard to ensure timely implementation of COVID-19 response activities. Pick out the name of the department and ministry under which it was developed. So guys, this National Monitoring Dashboard was developed on the recommendation of empowered group of 10 officers, which was established under Disaster Management Act of 2005. Okay, see, this empowered group of 10 officers was established under Disaster Management Act of 2005, and this National Monitoring Dashboard has been established by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances, which works under Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions. Okay, abhi National Monitoring Dashboard ka kafi requirement tha, because we all know COVID-19 puri duniya mein ek panic phaila chuka hai, and COVID-19 से निपटने के लिए हमें इस डैशबोर्ड की बहुत ज्यादा जरूरत थी. ओके, और इसमें कुछ प्रोविजंस ये हैं कि जो भी ग्रीवेंसेस होंगे उसका जो रिट्रेसल पीरियड है वो 3 दिन का है. मतलब ऑल डिपार्टमेंट्स शुड हैव टू रिट्रेस द ग्रीवेंसेस ऑफ द पर्सन विद इन 3 डेज, एंड देर आर सम टाइप्स ऑफ ग्रीवेंसेस विच आर रिलेटेड टू क्वारंटीन फैसिलिटीज, lockdown not being adhered to complaints, essential supplies related complaints, examination related complaints, evacuation requests from foreign countries. Alright, so ye National Monitoring Dashboard aaj ke liye kaafi zyada zarurat hai. Okay, and this was established by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. So what was the question? Pick out the name of department and ministry. Yes, so the answer is Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances, Ministry of Personal, Public Grievances and Pensions. Alright, so I hope this question is clear now. Next question is, defense budget as a percentage of GDP is decreasing every year from 2016-17. Which of the following is the correct reason for this? जो हमारा defense budget है as a percentage of GDP कम हो रहा है 2016-17 से, इसके लिए correct reason बताना है. तो हम इस table को अगर देखें तो हमें reason clearly समझ में आ जाएगा. तो in 2016 the defense budget was 3,40,000 crore and the GDP was around 1.5 trillion. In 2017, GDP increased to 1.7 trillion and the defense budget also increased to 3,59,000 crores. In 2018-19, the GDP increased to 1.9 trillion and defense budget increased to 4,04,000 crores. And in 2019-20, the defense budget is 4,31,000 crore and the GDP is around 2 trillion. So, देखो हो ये रहा है कि एज अ परसेंटेज ऑफ जीडीपी ये इसलिए कम हो रहा है बिकॉज जो हमारी जीडीपी है वो कंटिन्यूसली इंक्रीज हो रही है. देखिए, अगर हम डिफेंस बजट की तरफ ध्यान देंगे तो डिफेंस बजट लगातार हर फाइनेंशियल ईयर में इंक्रीज हुआ है, बट क्योंकि हमारा जीडीपी भी साथ साथ बढ़ रहा है तो एज अ परसेंटेज ऑफ जीडीपी वो डिफेंस का जो एक्सपेंडिचर है वो कम हो रहा है. सो देयरफॉर द आंसर इज इट इज ड्यू टू इंक्रीजिंग ट्रेंड इन द ग्रोथ ऑफ जीडीपी. ये क्वेश्चन आपके एग्जाम में आ सकता है और बहुत सारे कंफ्यूजिंग ऑप्शन दे सकते हैं, बट इसका सही आंसर है इट इज ड्यू टू द इंक्रीजिंग ट्रेंड इन ग्रोथ ऑफ जीडीपी दैट डिफेंस बजट एज अ परसेंटेज ऑफ जीडीपी इज डिक्रीजिंग एवरी ईयर फ्रॉम 2016-17. ऑलराइट, लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे इज द ट्राइबल कोऑपरेटिव मार्केटिंग डेवलपमेंट फेडरेशन ऑफ इंडिया ट्राइफेड हैज लॉन्च्ड Transformational program in March 2020 in partnership with institutes of national importance to develop tribal entrepreneurship. What is the name of the program? So, जो Trified है, वो 1987 में establish किया गया था under Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Okay, and इसका objective था socio-economic development of tribal people by developing a market for their products. Okay, इसका जो बनाने का ऑब्जेक्टिव था ट्राइफेड का वो था ट्राइबल लोगों का सोशियो इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट बाय डेवलपिंग अ मार्केट फॉर देयर products, okay, and it was established in 1987 under Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Now TRIFED ने एक program launch किया है in partnership with institutes of national importance to develop tribal entrepreneurs. हमें उसका नाम बताना है, तो let me tell you the name first. The name is Tech for Tribals, and under this program 5 crore tribal entrepreneurs का capacity building होगा, and they will impart entrepreneurship skills to forest produce gatherers which are enrolled under the Pradhan Mantri Bandhan Yojana. Okay, so 5 crore tribal entrepreneurship की capacity buildings and जो forest produce gatherers जो कि Pradhan Mantri Bandhan Yojana के अंदर enrolled है, उनको entrepreneurship skills provide कराई जाएगी. And under this program, there will be a training of 30 days with around 120 sessions. Okay, and under the curriculum, it is achievement, motivation, positive psychology, entrepreneurship competencies, capacity utilization, product positioning, grading, sorting, branding, packing, etc. And this program is supported by Ministry of MSME. So, ये काफी important program है, Tech for Tribals. ये exam में पूछा जा सकता है कि Tech for Tribals program किसने बनाया और किस ministry के अंदर काम करता है, किसने लॉन्च किया, किसके साथ लॉन्च किया एंड एक्सेट्रा. सो इट एम्स टू ट्रांसफॉर्म 5 करोड़ ट्राइबल एंटरप्रेन्योर्स बाय कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग एंड इम्पार्टिंग एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप स्किल टू फॉरेस्ट प्रोड्यूस गैदरर्स विच आर एनरोल्ड अंडर द प्रधानमंत्री बंधन योजना. एंड देयर इज अ ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम ऑफ 30 डेज विच इंक्लूड्स 120 सेशन एंड इट इज सपोर्टेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एमएसएमई एंड ऑफकोर्स इट हैज बीन लॉन्च बाय ट्राइफेड. ऑलराइट, so that's it. This was the last question for today. I hope you like the session. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Milte hain next session mein. Goodbye, take care, God bless.